Warriors, my friends, my extended family, welcome to another important video on my channel. Yes, there's a balloon behind me because Dennis is getting some serious brownie points today because it's my fiance's birthday. It's Robin's birthday today, and you can catch all the events on Instagram under @theanxietyguy. As well, if you want to learn more about the 12-week journey to healing health anxiety, you can click on this link right here, which will take you to the Health Anxiety Program. Learn more today. And friends, I want to get right into it. I really do today, because anxiety makes us overexert ourselves. Anxiety is this feeling that we have to stand guard at every moment of the day, just in case. And we tend to play a lot more defense in life with anxiety than play offense. And what I mean by that is we're always looking to prevent the worst possible scenario from happening rather than look to create something in our lives instead. Notice the difference. Defense, offense. When we start to heal our anxiety and transform ourselves, we find ourselves on offense more. We find ourselves within the creative process more. We find that we are using our imaginations for better purposes. This is important because right now you are unconsciously using your imagination for bad purposes, okay, to play defense. And what we're going to start doing is we're going to start using that imagination for better purposes, okay? Now, as you go through the day, you are overexerting yourself, okay? You are mentally overexerting yourself by overthinking every possible, worst possible scenario that's upcoming. You are emotionally overexerting yourself because you're falling for the ideas and you're falling for the feelings within you. You are behaviorally overexerting yourself because you're fighting through every single scenario that feels unfamiliar. Fight, 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 fight. And as we talked about, you are imaginatively overexerting yourself. You cannot heal your anxiety and transform your identity if you are so depleted and overly exerting yourself from moment to moment. Here's why. Because this feeds in to your fear-based perceptions, okay? And if your perceptions are always focused on preventing the worst from happening, again, you can never create what you want. And in order to heal anxiety, we have to be in that creative process, okay? So this video is about understanding what we have to do to not fight so much, therefore keep our willpower points, okay? Because the more fighting you do throughout the day, the less willpower points you're going to have throughout the day. And the less willpower points you have, the less creative you're going to be. I hope that makes sense, okay? And it's like we find ourselves in a cycle of familiarity. Worry can be so familiar over an extended period of time. We can even think that worry is a part of who we are. It's a part of our beliefs. It's a part of our persona. It's a part of our character. And the moment we stop worrying, we start to place these weird meanings behind that moment, right? We start to go, oh, now I'm being lazy, or now I'm being unproductive. No, none of those things. Society, the media, other people may make you feel that way, but the truth is, when you stop fighting, when you stop worrying, you are in the present moment. When you're in the present moment, you are making your own judgments around things, right? This is important. This is very, very important because healing anxiety to a high degree means that you are present more often throughout the day, right? The more present you are, the less exerting you're doing in terms of energy. The more present you are, the less you're fighting through the day and fighting through circumstances. So I have a few goals for us today to make sure that we don't feel like we're fighting so much throughout the day, and we are in fact allowing those willpower points to stay with us for a longer period of time. Okay? Number one is we need to expose ourselves with the goal of cooperation with the parts of us that fear, right? A lot of people suffering from anxiety, when I work with them through my programs, they start to realize that they can have a new relationship with the things that they fear, right? It's kind of like you're at the bar and you've got a very attractive woman or man at the bar, right? And it's an unfamiliar situation. It causes a certain degree of nervousness and uncertainty within you. You don't know how it's going to go, right? And so you're thinking to yourself now, should I approach this person or not? Oh, they're looking at me. Oh, they're looking away. Do they like me? Do they not like me? This is very, very similar to the relationship that you're going to start building with your own fears, because your fears are a product of your inner child's way of seeing things. Your fears are a product of your subconscious mind and body. So in essence, you are creating a new relationship with your fears and your own inner child. This is where the magic happens. This is where transformation happens. So when we expose ourselves to things, it's not about I'm going to expose myself and I'm just going to go for it and hopefully it all turns out all right and I hope that I have as little anxiety as possible. Notice the word that I'm using very often here, the word hope, right? Hope is a great place to start, but it's an awful strategy for healing anxiety. Remember that. So what we need to do is we need to have the right attitude and mindset going into our exposure work. Before you expose yourself, you need to go, okay, there's a part of me here, a part of me that fears this particular scenario. Or there's obviously a part of me here that fears something in the future because I'm feeling an anxiety symptom. And what I want to do is I want to create a better relationship with that part of me that is afraid. Can you see how this works? It's kind of like taking your own child by the hand and saying, honey, notice in the closet there are no boogeymen, right? Notice under the bed there are no boogeymen. So it's safe to go to sleep right now. And then you tuck the child in, right? You give him a kiss on the forehead and your speed is very slow. You're not going very fast. And you provide safety to that child. It's the same thing when you start to expose yourself, okay? So before you expose yourself and do any exposure work, okay, check in with yourself and understand that you are there to comfort those fearful parts of you, therefore have a neutral experience. And when you have a neutral or even pleasant experience, you are regaining your willpower points. You are not exerting yourself so much anymore, and this is a good thing. The second thing is we want to change the meaning of our fears without using force, such as when we use positive affirmations in the hopes of it working, right? There's a lot of people out there that think that turning on positive affirmations and hoping that it kind of installs something new into us will work. Not necessarily. That's a form of hoping and fighting. We don't want that, right? We want to be certain that what we're doing is working and will work for us. So we have to understand when we're using force to change things and when we're not, right? Using force is falling victim to the emotional inner child's perspective over what we must do. Moving into a scenario that we are afraid of or creating a better relationship with our fears come from the conscious mind, the adult mind, the experienced mind. Now what starts to happen is when we don't use force and we start to allow things to happen more often, What's happening is we are updating our belief systems. We are updating our identities, right? And doesn't your belief systems need an update? If you look at the majority of your beliefs today, are they similar to the ones that you had when you were growing up as a child, between conception and about the age of 7? If it's the case, you must understand that it's time for an upgrade, an update. And the way we do it is this way, without forcing. Through building better relationships and collaborations with the parts of us that we've been looking to run from and we've neglected for far too long. Can you imagine a child coming to you and saying, "Daddy, I'm afraid of X," and you're going, not now, maybe later, right? Or go play with your video games for a while and forget about that thing. What's going to happen? It's just going to come full circle back. Right? So you would never do that to your child. You would help them progressively work through that fear. And that's the same thing we have to do without using force. Because remember, this video is about you at the end of the day feeling like you had a progress-filled day number one. You didn't fight through the day number two. And number three, at the end of the day, you don't feel absolutely exhausted. Okay, because if you feel absolutely exhausted or you feel like you need to take a nap every single day around 12 to 2 p.m., then you're overexerting yourself in some way, mentally, emotionally, behaviorally, you know, imaginatively, whatever it is. Okay, now, number three, our goal is to, and this is very, very important, is to implement the act of surrendering to any childhood belief that needs an update, therefore not feeding into it. Surrender, this is important, my friends, surrender doesn't mean giving in to. It means to no longer be led by. If you can understand that, this is going to take you to places that you never expected to go, right? So we're not here to make a massive leap from one place to another. We're here to work with those beliefs that are outdated. Okay? And when you can apply a sense of surrendering to those beliefs, not falling for them, remember, right? Not being led by them, but surrendering to them, they lose their energies. Okay? So the biggest problem we have right now with anxiety is we are feeding into things, okay? You wake up in the morning, you get an idea, you feed into it. You're going through the day, you feel an anxiety symptom, you're feeding into it. You have a feeling at nighttime, you feed into it, right? These are perceptions coming from your inner child, and you don't have to feed into anything you think or feel. This is important. Don't believe everything you think, and don't believe everything that you feel. So, my friends, I want to go over this one more time so that we truly understand the message from today's video. Number one, expose yourself. Do expose your work with the goal of cooperating with your fearful parts. Secondly, change the meaning of your fears without using force. And thirdly, surrender to your childhood beliefs, okay, when they arise, therefore not feeding into those beliefs anymore, right? The act of surrendering allows us to create new ideas, new beliefs, new behaviors, and a new us. It doesn't mean succumbing to, it means not feeding into anymore. I want you to comment below and tell me, what's the biggest epiphany you gained from this video? And I'll be there, side by side with you every step of the way to not only heal anxiety, but to transform yourself from the inside out. And I want to leave you with this. Transform your pain into wisdom, and you will never hurt another day in your life. I promise you. Remember, that you are more than anxiety. I love you all, and I'll see you soon.